I do need you. I love you so much.
Petra, I want you to listen very carefully to me.
What is it? What's wrong?
It's Emma. They found her in the river. She's dead. Petra, I'm so sorry.
She wasn't strong enough. I expected too much of her.
Look, it's pretty natural to feel guilty. There's nothing you could have done.
She couldn't handle the guilt. I should have got to him before she did.
What do you mean?
I should have killed him before he got to him.
Petra, are you telling me the truth?
For God's sake, why should I lie?
To protect Emma. Emma killed your father, didn't she?
That's not
true. And now you're covering...
Stop trying to drag her down to the good kid!
Look, Emma's dead. And if you leave things as they are, Emma will have died for nothing.
Conditions are quite satisfactory at Wentworth. We believe the public to be aware of that.
Mm. Well, could you tell us then what the inmates have decided the legacy should be spent on?
Oh, firstly, let me make it clear that prisoners are in no position to make decisions which could affect departmental policy. We run penal institutions, not luxury hotels.
Tell us something we don't know.
Shut up, this is important.
Luxuries were requested.
Yes. The department views swimming pools and video recorders as frivolous and therefore unnecessary.
But surely a pool would provide a healthy outlet in the way of
exercise. Hasn't got the most beautiful voice. It gives me goosebumps.
Well, it would seem you're the only one.
The problem is that once we give in to these outrageous demands, where will it end? These things have a way of snowballing.
What's going on?
But don't you feel that as a democratic society,
you're about to witness an execution?
Review issues like this?
Well, certainly. In this particular case, we have reviewed the situation very closely.
I'll bet.
However, it doesn't change things. Just because some inmates have inherited money doesn't alter the fact that they are still criminals.
I think we all feel a bit like that today. Anything I can do to help? You're not still thinking about Emma, are you? Kids of her age are always
worried. Emma's dead.
Oh, love, I am sorry. How did it happen?
They found her in the river.
hell?
Scott told me. I don't know whether I should have been, but I've told him the whole story.
Well, I knew it already anyway, but it's good to get it off your chest.
How did he know? No one else but me knew that Emma killed Dad.
How did the doc take all this?
He's relieved. He said I'll be acquitted. But I'd rather Emma was kept out of it for her and Mom's sake.
No, Petra. You've got to tell the cops the truth. Why on earth should you and Scott be punished for something you didn't do?
Please, Bea, just leave me alone. I've got to think.
You don't need to think. What you need is some sleep, my girl. Come on. And just remember, you did this because you loved Emma. But you can't help her now.
Give me the keys and get out of here.
This is my joint. I should be telling you to piss off. You run away from home or something?
It's my business.
Fair enough. Look, why don't you put that thing down? I won't do nothing, honest. What's your name?
What's it to you?
Well, my name's Bill. Some of my mates call me Tinker. It's because of me big feet. Always getting me into trouble.
No, it's your man.
Do you want a cuppa?
All right. It's no bad bit of machinery you got out there. I had this real cute poster in me cell and... Look, all I want to do is get a couple of hours sleep and then I'll nick off, all right?
No worries. You find the waterbed sprung a leak?
Well, I just have to make do then, won't I? You can have the bed.
Come on, ladies, please don't talk. We've done it, Miss Shelley.
All right, Lizzie, I'm coming. Oh, Lizzie, I've never known you to be so anxious to get to the showers.
Oh, Mrs. Barry, it's glamorous. Just look at her.
Oh,
Lord. Oh, Doc! Oh, God, Doc, come quickly. It's Glenys. She's awfully sick.
Just calm down,
Lizzie. Oh,
you've
got to be quick. She's burning up.
Well, thank heavens you got in early. She's in a terrible state, Doctor.
Well, I think we can expect at least another 24 hours of this.
Oh, God, Doc, you're going to help me. Give me a shot, please.
Oh, she's going to be all right, Doc. She frightened the daylights out of me.
She's going to be fine, Lizzie. Now, just take it easy, Glenys. You're going to be okay.
I feel like I'm bloody dying. Give me a shot, Doc.
Do you want me to sit with her, Doctor?
No, Lizzie, you go and have your shower. We wouldn't want you to miss your breakfast now, would we? She's going to be okay.
Do you want me to arrange a transfer to a hospital?
No, she'll be all right here, I think.
Are you sure?
Just make sure she's checked regularly.
Oh, give me some stuff, you bastard.
No, you're going to make it. You're going to be all right, Glenys. I'll pop in later and see how she is.
Right. Try and relax. Come on.
This time I'm getting away as far as I can and like to start again. So 15 grand would help me start my cafe, and then once I get going, anyone getting out can come and have a free feed.
Now the letters come pouring in.
Oh, would you believe that? They must think the prisoners are awfully naive. I mean, just look at them all. Do you think we should bother giving them to the women?
Oh, I can't see any harm in it, Meg, as long as they're all vetted, of course. Don't you worry about them, Coral. I'll get one of the officers to check them. Quiet night.
apparently. I mean, Colleen was expecting a minor riot after that program, but all it seemed to do was depress the women more than anything else.
Oh, yes. The interview.
There is a big difference between requests and demands.
You're now preaching that... to the converted, remember?
I'm sorry.
Morning, Miss Ferguson.
Morning, Governor. There's a delegation from Passive visiting the prison tomorrow. Would you both see that everyone's notified?
Passive?
Protect Australian society against violence. It's a holier-than-thou group with nothing better to do than shove their noses in when they're not needed.
A bit harsh, Miss Ferguson. Especially when their ideas on rehabilitation are what we should be trying to achieve. They'll be here tomorrow, 11 a.m.
Oh, Joan, there's a phone message here from your niece, Lucy.
When did that come?
Oh, just a while ago. I didn't know she was staying with you.
Oh, yeah.
Talking about me or the
bot? Oh, you got a paper?
Yep. Sitting right next to the milk. Yeah, I wish they'd eat delivers. I'd give anything for a nice fat omelette smothered in bacon.
Page 3. You'll see how important I am on Hush Hush. Not even a picture.
Yeah, thank God for that. I'd hate the coffee to curdle.
I rate 5 sentences. Mustn't be too worried about finding me.
Listen, you might only rate page 3 in there. You'd be sure you're number one on the cops list at the moment. Better lie low here for a while longer.
Well, I haven't got any money. And I won't bludge.
Look, I know what it's like when you first get out, legit or otherwise. Besides, everything around here is free. If you know what I mean.
Oh, yeah. The good fairy.
That's me. Tinkerbell, your fairy friend.
All my friends are locked up. Probably never see him again.
Sure you will. Mates don't lose touch, else they wouldn't be mates. You're missing them, huh?
The only real mates I ever had. Especially Lizzie.
Well, Emma, she's probably fretting too, wondering if you're all right. Hey, listen, why don't you write her a letter? I'll post it the same way she'll have it tomorrow.
Oh, that'd be stupid. The screws will take one look at the postmark and then where will I be?
So I go to Wentworth and post it from there.
But that'll take hours.
Yeah? So what are mates for?
Got anything better than a cigarette packet to write on?
I'm sorry if you thought I overstepped my boundaries, Mrs. Reynolds. But as she was a patient, I felt it best to tell Petra of Emma's death.
Why is it I get the feeling that you knew Petra before she came here?
Mrs. Reynolds,
please remember, Scott, I'm no fool.
Petra is my fiancée.
Oh, good Lord. What next?
I can assure you any contact has been strictly on a medical basis. I haven't broken any...
But you encouraged those examinations, didn't you? If it hadn't been for Robert's refusals, you'd have been continually together. I take it that note Mason had was from Petra to you?
Yes, I'm afraid it was.
A little late for apologies, I'm afraid. Just accepting the position under the circumstances was a gross misrepresentation on your part, but to involve the other women in your intrigue is intolerable.
Right, would you like my resignation now? Wait till the department
sees the report. Naturally, I want you to stay. But I do have to seriously consider reporting the matter. In the meantime, your contact with Roberts will be on a purely legitimate basis, otherwise you leave me no alternative.
Oh, good. I can't read Foxy's letter without me specs. Would you read it to me, please, love?
Yeah, okay. My dear Elizabeth, delighted to receive your correspondence. I realise how difficult it must be for you to spare time to write between your charitable and social engagements.
Hey, I don't want that lot to know all about my personal life.
Oh, no kidding.
No doubt you will be travelling again shortly. And it's for this reason that I should like to extend an invitation for you to be my guest. Who does he think you are, Lady Muck?
Oh, he's got such a perfect setup over there. I didn't want to disappoint him. It's only a bit of fun.
Listen, you take nothing from no one. Why should they give him?
Phyllis, where's your queen? What's going on over there?
Phyllis reckons that these letters are a load of bull, and I reckon some are really on the level. There are a lot of hard cases out there.
Oh, crap. Look, why should they get out, though? We're the ones that are in here. They're out there, after all.
You've forgotten that a lot of us find it a bloody sight harder out there.
Yes, I know what it's like. I had a terrible time between husbands.
Listen to Daddy's little girl. You wouldn't know what going hungry means.
You leave her alone anyway. You can't talk. You don't want to share that money because all you want is to get your grubby little hands on it all.
Now listen to this
one. No, thank you. I think I've heard quite enough.
There, you see what you've done? All that shouting and carrying on.
Being broken by yourself is the hardest part. But now I've met this real beauty.
How's it going?
Oh, nearly done. Did you find your mate?
Yeah. Would you believe she's gone and got herself married? Good, she brought the tits off me. All she could talk about was Arby and the kids. Don't know how she can stand it.
Doesn't sound like such a bad lurk to me. At least they got each other.
You gotta be kidding. Imagine tying yourself down like that for the rest of your life. Good, her and me used to have some ripper times. Now look at her.
Well, I reckon she's got the right idea. I mean, look, we're ripping it up. It's got me back in stir every time. No, I've been thinking about it, Tink. This time I'm going to get as far away as I can and start again with a decent bloke, kids and all.
Yeah? Yeah, I guess anything's better than running from the cops. Hell, I nearly tied the apron strings myself once. He was having a heavy affair with his bike. Do me a favour, it would have been a nightmare.
Yeah, well, your nightmare, my dream. Only nowadays it costs money to make dreams come true.
Should be giving me a shot, not taking me blood.
Just hold it just a second, Glennis.
Oh, just one shot, please, Doc.
I think you might have picked up a little bug, that's all. Probably explains why you feel worse than you normally would.
Nothing's worse than this, Doc. Just one little shot, please.
Now, as soon as this is over, we'll know exactly what sort of treatment to give you.
All right, have Inspector Thorne taken through to the interview room, would you? Is Mrs. O'Shea still there? Good. Would you have her collect Roberts from the laundry? Thanks, Coral. Now, where were we? Oh, yes, the department.
How could you forget?
Well, I can understand your disappointment, but you saw the interview. It's highly unlikely they'll approve anything that even looks like comfort for the prisoners.
I wonder if they'd approve of us donating it to the Screws Benevolent Fund.
Well, perhaps a charitable organisation is the answer. We'll get together and try and come up with an alternative. But let me know as soon as possible. I've got a TV interview this evening, and they'll be hounding me for an answer.
Yeah, fair enough. Oh, I was wondering if it would be possible to have Judy at the meeting. It might be handy to have someone who's impartial.
I don't see why not. In fact, I'll arrange it now.
He promised me he wouldn't touch her. She was 13 years old. And he...
So this was the only time he forced himself on her?
Yes. He'd come home drunk. Emma didn't stand a chance. After he went to sleep, she got a knife from the kitchen and then she stabbed him again and again. She phoned me straight away. She was in a terrible state. I went to the house. You know, when I saw him, I was glad. He finally got what he deserved. I took Emma out and cleaned her up. After that, I put my fingerprints on the knife and then phoned the police.
That was quite an ordeal for both of you. I only wish you'd come to us straight after Emma found you.
All I could think of was protecting her from any more ugliness. Anyway, the truth's finally out.
Yes. Unfortunately, it's too late for you now. We've a signed confession from you. A murder weapon with your fingerprints. And the other parties in the case are dead. I'm afraid you'll still have to stand trial for murder, Miss Roberts. I'm sorry.
See why we have to have Jude there anyway. She'll probably want to give the lot to Driscoll.
You don't shut up, Phyllis. You'll need the lot to pay your hospital bills. Oh, if you don't slow down, Lizzie, you'll be right in there with her.
Oh, Bea. I've just seen Glynis. She's awfully sick. Should see the way she's mucked up your old bed.
Serves her right. She put it on herself. And the same thing goes for Maxine. She should be in here, finishing her sentence, not out there dodging cops.
Now, why have you got a flea in your ear?
What happened?
I'm back where I started.
Did you tell them everything?
I told them, but I can't prove it, so the charge still stands.
Oh, the stupid-looking buggers!
You can't blame them, Lizzie. I planned it so they'd think I'd done it.
Looks like you did a good job.
Did I? Emma's dead. Maybe it's right that I'm tried for murder, not for Dad's. For Emma's.
Oh, come on, you can't be blamed for something Emma did.
No, you only did it for the best, love.
I was trying to, but I only made it worse for her. Just think what she must have gone through before she died. Guilt over Dad. Guilt because I was in here and no one to talk to.
Oh. Bea, you've got a visitor.
Oh, all right, Mrs. Z.
Are you all right, Petra? I mean, if you don't want to work.
No, I'll be okay. I'd rather stay here, Mrs. Morris.
I'll look after her, Mrs. M. Come on, love. Come and sit down. I've got some biggies somewhere. Here we go. Brandy snacks. Screws only buy the best.
Are you feeling jittery?
Yeah, just a bit.
You don't have a cuppa.
Ta. Listen, can I bought a fag?
Yeah.
I know I've been going through them, but I'll pay you back honest.
Forget it. You're going to have to worry about it. Remember we was talking before about dough? Getting enough to get started?
Yeah.
I think I could lay my hands on 7,000 or 8,000.
How?
My brother. Works in a factory near here.
Forget it.
Oh, you don't even know what I was going to say.
Want to lay a packet of fags on it?
Yeah.
And you're thinking about us doing it over, right?
Yeah, but there's more to it than that.
And your brother's going to set it up for us on the inside.
Here.
Nah, don't worry about it.
I'll go and keep him. There's only a few left anyway. What'll be a pushover, Max? All we've got to do is move in and move out with over a couple of thousand. Road want an even cut.
Does he want an even cut of the time we'd finish up doing?
All right, forget it. I'll go and post your list.
Well, you'll be needing petrol, it's hell of a way. Here.
I got a tank full gratis last night. Cheer up, you look as if a mule's kicked you.
Let's just hope they believe her story in court.
Yeah, poor kid, what a mess. A bit like this money problem. I never thought I was going to have that worry.
Any ideas of what you're going to do with it?
I don't know what we're going to spend it on. The department won't let us use it on ourselves. The women will bitch if we spend it on anyone else.
Well, maybe it's a good idea the department's put its foot down.
Why?
Well, Mum wouldn't want the money spent on, well, luxury items.
Well, then what do we spend it on? Have you seen any of those cards and letters that have been coming in? Well, a lot of them are cons, but some of them are genuine. $20,000 won't go farther.
Have you thought of investing it?
How are you going to let my beard?
Come along, you want to keep Arthur Richards waiting.
I'll do him good.
B, come along.
Okay, okay. Look, how much do you reckon we get back on $20,000?
Oh, $3,000, $4,000 a year?
Good on you, Mrs. M. We're going to make Mum proud. You reckon we should let him out?
It took you long enough.
Oh, I'm very sorry, Mr. Richards, but I was in conference with my financial advisor.
Wait outside.
I have been in touch with our legal department, Smith. They tell me you haven't a hope of bringing a successful suit against the department.
Oh, really? Well, you get used to long odds in here. I think I'll just take my chances.
Then you're a fool.
That's as may be. But I am going to hit the department and the money belt will go down trying.
With this legacy and now this lawsuit, I think you prisoners are forgetting your position.
No one's memory's that bad.
No. Well, perhaps I may have a word with the governor. The whole running of this prison needs tightening up. Full security at all times. Censorship of all mail. We can't have these lax attitudes.
We've been through all that before.
Then you know what I'm talking about.
Yes, blackmail.
No. Discipline.
And if I drop the suit?
Well, it would make it easier on everybody, Smith. Of course, the decision is yours.
All right, everyone.
Oh, God, beam me, old ticker.
What's wrong?
I've just been speaking to Arthur Richards, and he says if I go ahead with this lawsuit, the department is going to slap full security and censorship on the lot of us.
They can't do that.
Oh,
don't you bet on it. What are you going to do, Bean?
I don't know yet. I thought you should have a say in it.
Yeah, well, I say back down. It's your fight, not ours.
You would, you yellow-looking bugger. I say go after him, Bean.
What? And she ends up with a bag full of dough. And what do we get? Screws breathing down our necks day and night. You can count me out.
Well, he's not the sort of man I'd go after. He's got mean little eyes.
Thanks, Pixie.
What he's trying to do is immoral, Bee. I think you should go after them.
He'll spread the word, try and find out how everyone else feels. And he can tell them that compared to Richards, Douglas was a choir boy. If he gets away with this, he's going to have us right where he wants us, and I'd hate to see that happen.
Wally, listen, I'm on my way out now. Frances is going to cook dinner tonight. Maybe I'll need to give her a bit of a push.
After last night's effort, I think I might let it slip my mind. Oh, look, I hope this legacy business gets cleared up. It's giving Anne one hell of a headache.
Yeah, it's got bee bamboozled, too. Yeah. Just a minute. Is this concern for your fellow workers or more than the passing interest in Anne? Huh?
Much more. Go on, you're missing
me. No, don't you rush me. Now, how long's this been going on for?
Oh, don't worry, you're not missing anything. We've got a few hassles to sort out.
Yeah, like what?
Well, it could be a few professional conflicts. I mean, she's got a very demanding job. We work in the same area, and we're not kids anymore.
Oh, well, I don't see how that's any problem. You two make a great pair.
Thanks for the encouragement. On the strength of that, I think I'll ring her and try and talk her into a nice, quiet, cozy evening at home, eh?
Well, you tell her she's a lucky girl and that I'm on my way.
Invested? Geez, I thought the racehorse was a lousy idea. We'll never see any bloody money if we invest.
Will you let me finish? Yeah, keep your bloody big mouth shut if you can't come up with anything better. Go on, Bee.
Mrs. M reckons we can get approximately $4,000 return per annum.
Oh, that's wonderful. Every year? Well, what'll we do with it?
We give it away.
Give all that money away?
It's bloody mad. As you can see, Bee's going to need all the help she can get.
Yes, I realise that. Hello, girls.
Oh, good day, Jude. Come and sit here.
Thanks, love.
We give it away to any woman who's leaving Wentworth and who needs cash.
Why should we give it to people that are getting out when we're stuck in here?
Because you can't use it in here. The time you need dough is when you're on the outside. We assess every woman who's being released as to how much she's earned in here, what her setup is on the outside, and how much she needs to give her a fresh start. And we give her that from the fund. Then hopefully she's got a chance to go straight. What do you say?
Ripper. Good old mum. And it'll be just what she wanted too.
Well, I think it's a lovely idea. Well, when I get out of here, there'll be lots of things I'll need to get started again.
Like what? A truckload of confetti? Oh. I think it sucks.
How many times have you been inside, Phyllis?
Oh, about, well, I don't know.
Yes, you'd need a computer to work it out. And why is it that you keep getting back inside?
Because I keep getting caught, don't I?
Oh. Well, have you ever thought of going straight?
Of course I have. You don't stand a chance.
Well, this is the sort of scheme that could give you one. It could have saved Susie Driscoll from those creeps. There are times when I could have used it, and Hazel, and I could name a lot more. Now, we got a chance here to do something for ourselves. Let's take it.
So, who's for the fun?
Oh, good on you.
Oh, good old mum. But it's got to have a name. A fund's got to have a name, like the Lord Mayor's Fund.
No, we've got one of those.
You can call it the Fresh Start Fund.
Yes, the Fresh Start Fund.
Does everyone agree with that?
Yeah.
Okay, then that's it. I'll catch Mrs. Reynolds before she leaves and give her the details. At least the department can't pick holes in this one. You coming, Jude?
Yeah. Good on you, girl.
See you later.
It's a great idea, isn't it, Lizzie?
Yeah. Probably little Maxie wouldn't have thought about running off if she'd known this was around to help and make a fresh start.
Thanks for coming, Jude. You were great.
Oh, well, I figured we had more of a chance. We both sat on her.
I want you to get something out for me.
Oh, God, I hope it's not a slide trombone. Am I allowed to ask what it is?
Court and insurance policy. The bloke from the department's getting a bit heavy. That might just bring him to heel.
I guess Maxine showed up at Driscoll.
Is she okay?
Yeah, she twisted her ankle during the break, but she seems to be all right.
Must be ketchup.
She said Ferguson set her up.
I knew there was something fishy about it. That Walker kid must have something on her.
Well, she didn't have much time for explanations.
If only we could pin it on Ferguson.
You can bet she's covered herself.
So what's new?
Well, how'd it go?
Perfecto, Mrs. M. Can I see Mrs. Reynolds?
Right, I'll take you through.
Amazing what you can achieve when everyone cooperates, huh?
Never said a truer word, Mrs. Morris. Never said a truer word.
I can see you're glad it's all over.
Oh, it's not just that. I think the whole thing's just wonderful. Well, I know it's silly, but... Well, I felt proud when Smith told me what they were planning to do with the legacy.
It was a good thing, all right.
And they're getting television coverage, too. I think people should know that prisoners can come up with worthwhile projects to help themselves.
That's right. I'm sharing you with the television audience, aren't I? What time's it on?
Oh, not for another hour or so.
I don't want to miss it.
I'd rather like to see it myself. I've never been on TV before.
Pity Paul's not going to see it. Not every night your mum's on TV.
Don't really think he and his friends would have bothered taking a television set on a camping trip.
Do you miss him?
A little. He works such odd hours, he's really here anyway. But I do miss him.
I'd like to keep you company. All of the time.
I'm glad you've said that. I didn't particularly want to ask you.
Think we've got nothing better to do than check out every Darrow ramp. Check that nobody makes a run for it out the back, I'll take the front. Anyone in there?
Money, it was their own decision.
But the department did stop them spending the money on what they termed luxury items.
That's so, and they were initially disappointed. But they see the fund as a more worthwhile use for the legacy.
And how do you feel about the decision?
Very proud.
Thank you. By the way, Mrs. Reynolds, the channel is donating a small gift for the women at Wentworth, 2 dozen bottles of champagne.
Champagne?
You can relax, it's non-alcoholic.
I am relieved, but I'm afraid they'll be disappointed.
We've been talking to Mrs. Anne Reynolds, Governor at Wentworth Detention Centre.
That's it. Good on you, Mrs. Reynolds. Hey, give us another swig of that, love. Right up the top will do.
Suddenly we're the do-gooders.
We'll make a change, eh? Oh, well, I think we're wonderful. I wish I'd been in Mrs. Reynolds' place, though. Wasn't that interview gorgeous?
Now, girl.
Okay, come on, ladies. Finish up your drinks. Time for lock-up.
Oh, come on, Mrs. Powell. Just one more round to toast the fun.
Yeah, come on, Mrs. Powell.
All right, one more.
Wish I could wake up with a hangover in the morning.
Bad chance. How about you two join us and we'll have a toast from both sides?
Yeah, come on, Mrs. M. Yeah.
Well, it is non-alcoholic.
Thank you.
Right, everyone, on your feet. To the Fresh Start Fund and to Mum. Let's hope it's the success she would have wanted.
God love her. To Mum.
To Mum.
And to little Maxie, and I hope she slips away from those lousy buggers.
Maxie, I'll be in there.
Thank you, ladies. Put your cups down and get out.
Why? Don't let me. Might be my maiden aunt.
Hello? Oh, hello. No, I was just in the shower. Oh, did you? Well, thank you. A little nervous. Yes, I'd love that. Yes, all right, thank you for calling. Bye.
And how is your aunt?
Do you realize that you were making love to a national celebrity last night?
Oh, it went clean out of my head.
Mine too. I'm told I look lovely.
I could have told them that.
Oh, God, Tink, I thought it was the cops again.
Just your friendly neighbourhood milkman.
You're a real good mate, you know that? Would have been sprung for sure last night.
Yeah, well, it was a close one. You still might. You hungry?
Oh, you bet. Hey, where'd you get to last night?
Well, after I gave the cops a slip, I went round to my brother's. Talked about that job. You reckon it's a go.
And?
I'm gonna do it.
Huh. Best of luck.
Yeah, well, I'm getting short on cash myself. I'm getting sick of this dump. So after I do the job, I'm going to piss off up north.
Reckon I might take over your lease for you.
Even this place is out of your category.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
So what are you going to do?
Oh, don't worry about me. I can look after myself. Are you really sure about this job?
Yeah. It's all fixed up. Ray's usually last to leave. He's going to close the safe and he's going to lock it. Then he's going to fix the alarm so it looks like it's buggered up. All I've got to do is walk in, take the money and walk out. Sure you don't want any of it?
Look, I already told you, no way.
Tell you what. When I piss off, I'll take you with me. Just get you out of town.
What do you mean?
And you can ride with me far as you like.
Stick it.
What do you mean?
Look, you're already paying for me food and me smokes. Now you want to pull a job, take all the risks and take me along as a passenger. I don't bludge off me mates like that.
Oh, shut up, will you? So what are you going to do? We'll hang around here till the cops come back? Well?
I guess I'll have to come in with you.
You sure?
Well, like you say, got nothing better to do, have I?
You didn't waste much time.
You've had time to think it over.
Well, I'm going ahead with the suit.
Then I'll see that this place is shut up so tightly you won't be able to breathe.
Oh, is that all?
That's all.
Okay. See you in court.
Get out!
Now, is there any way to speak to Mrs. Powell?
What is this, Smith?
Oh, it's only a carbon copy. Maybe it's not too clear. No, that's all right. Just covers the bombing and raises a few questions about security in the prison. And, of course, it mentions the fact you tried to make me sign a waiver to clear the department and the deal if I dropped the lawsuit.
Where's the original?
It was quite safe. On the outside.
This doesn't mean a thing.
Well, I think we'll let the editor of the Dispatch decide that.
Has he got a copy?
Not yet.
Will you settle out of court?
It'll cost you $30,000.
$30,000. You weren't even hurt, Smith. You'll be lucky to get $10,000. All right. $15,000.
$20,000.
I might be able to get approval for that amount.
The bloke that got killed, Bill Hunt, he had a wife and kids, and I want them to get half.
You're very generous with the department's money.
He was very generous with his life.
I want that letter.
It'll be destroyed when I get the money.
That's blackmail.
Oh, no. That's discipline.
Mrs. Henderson, how do you do? Mr. Maguire? And Mr. Payne, our governor, Mrs. Reynolds.
I hope we're not being a nuisance.
No, not at all. I've heard about the good work you do. I just hope your visit here helps you with your research.
Yes, we've already put them through their paces at Woodridge and Barnhurst. Now we're anxious to see what you're doing here.
Well, unfortunately, I can't escort you through personally, but if you'll come through, I'll arrange for Officer Barry to take you.
Morning.
Mr. Richards, this is the group from Passive. Mr. Richards is extremely busy.
We can see that.
You just hold on there. It'll pass, love. Clemens. God, you're in a bad way. Can you hear me, love? Clemens. Oh. Hey, somebody! Help me! Mrs. M! Mrs. Help!
Well, let's hope they get what they're after, but I'm afraid Mrs. Henderson looked as though she was slumming.
Oh, just one moment, please.
Scott, it's for you. Do you want to take it here?
Sure. Dr. Collins.
How's the tour going?
Yes.
Oh, I think Officer Barry will bustle them round. Mm-hmm. They'll take a few notes, leave, and that'll be that. And then we can get on with it. Yeah, this one needs adjustment before it's put back.
Right.
Right. So I understand we're going there straight away. Mrs. Reynolds? That was the health department. That blood sample I took from Glenys Ladd shows she has a rare tropical disease. It's called Lassa fever, and there's never been a case in this country before.
They must have made a mistake.
No mistake. Wentworth's under strictest quarantine. Nobody is to be allowed in or out until further notice.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare. Christmas too, when morning comes around.